The shock cord in your tent poles is stretched, and it needs to be replaced. But all the videos on the internet make it so complicated. You need all kinds of stuff, like tape, a Sharpie, thread. I had to dig out my ex-girlfriend's bobby pin, vice grips. Vice grips? You know I'm a crazy lunatic. But we don't need all this stuff, my friends. The first step is to get rid of all this crap. Well, I'm gonna hold on to my ex-girlfriend's bobby pin. She was really nice. But it can be way simpler than this. Let's not waste any more time. Let's get started.
Welcome to Sweller Than Dweller.
Other videos will tell you the first step is to get the old shock cord out. And when you do this, you need to carefully number the poles to mark each of their positions or put tape on the pole and write on the tape, because the position is very important. Well, this is true, but we don't need to mark them because we're not just going to pull the old shock cord out and let them fall all over the place. That old shock cord might be worn out, but let it help you one more time. Let it do most of the work for you. Other videos will tell you you need a bobby pin and thread or a piece of wire to thread the new cord through the poles. There's a so much easier way. Like I said, let's let the old shock cord help us out. Take the cap off of one end of your poles to reveal the old shock cord and the knot in it. Loosen this knot just enough so that you can tie in the end of your new shock cord. With it secured, you can then magically start sliding the poles onto your new shock cord. The old shock cord will naturally act as an anchor. Just make sure your knot joining the two cords is nice and tidy and as small as possible. You might have to massage the knot a little bit to get it started through some of the poles. You see, the poles are never going to get mixed up because we're never taking them off the cord. Why would we take them off the cord? It's there to help us. Once you've got it threaded through to the other end, undo the knot and remove the old shock cord. Now you want to make sure that you cut the new shock cord to just the right length to get the right tension. You don't want it too loose, but you definitely don't want it too tight either, because that'll just wear it out sooner. Make sure your pole is assembled and each section is tightly in place. Now pull the shock cord so there's a little bit of tension and pinch it with your fingers to hold it in place. Now disassemble each section of the pole one by one, and you'll see as you do this, the cord actually gets tighter and tighter. This is why when the pole is assembled, you only want it just tight enough to hold the poles together. Now, unless you live in your tent, the poles are going to spend most of their time disassembled, and this is when the cord will be stretched to its tightest. And if it's too tight, it's just going to wear out sooner. So once you've found that perfect length to give you the nice balance between being just tight enough to hold the poles nicely together, while still being loose enough to not overly stretch it when the poles are disassembled, you've got it just right. Now you can put a knot in it, put the end cap back on, cut it, and your pole is ready to go. Your poles are probably going to have a few sections of shock cord, so you're going to have to repeat this process a few more times. But it's going to be easy, because now you're an expert. Now, over time, even though you've done an excellent job, your cord may lose some of its elasticity, and the poles will once again become a little bit too loose when they're assembled. Simply remove one of the end caps, loosen the knot, and retie it to snug things up. You should be able to do this a few times before the shock cord eventually loses too much of its elasticity. When that time hits, it's time to use your newfound skills to replace the shock cord once again. You see, my friends, we got the job done, and we didn't need any of that extra stuff. We did it nice and simple. So if you don't just think I'm some sort of crazy lunatic, then I'd be humbled if you consider giving the video a thumbs up and maybe even subscribing to the channel. It's the only way you can support me and let me know you like what I'm doing and you want me to continue. Until next time, keep on enjoying that tent.